Renfield, your accounting man can tell us where the black man's pockets are. You do know where they are, right?
Yes, I do. Well, most of them, anyway.
Most of them? What do you mean, most of them?
Now, don't shout. If you shout, I shall not help you at all. And besides, what am I to gain from all of this? You'll kill your vampires, and I'll end up rotting back in my cell. I want guarantees.
Guarantees?
Yes, guarantees. If all of this works out, I want to get out. Yes, that's what I want.
Renfield, what if I were to tell you? We don't need your help.
Don't need my help? But don't be silly, Professor. Of course you need my help.
Mr. Renfield, we already know that some of the vampire's coffins are in the Carfax Chapel.
You do? But how?
What you need to know, though, is if Dracula is among them.
No. No. This coffin isn't there. I don't know where it is. He's much too smart to tell anyone that.
Then you are of no use to us. So I'm the back itself.
Wait! Wait! I know a way you can find out where he is, though.
If this is a trick, it won't work.
No trick! No trick at all! There's someone in this house who can tell you exactly where he is! Miss Lucy Westenra!
That's absurd! The girl's never even left this house. How could she possibly?
Wait, Peter. It all makes sense. How else could Peter have known about Renfield's connection to Dracula so quickly?
She hasn't had time to.
She hasn't had time to bond with him, and Renfield certainly didn't tell her.
But how could she have known then?
There's only one explanation. When they become Dracula's, they are one mind. His. His hold up his pussy is very strong. He can read her every thought. Perhaps he can reverse the process.
What do you mean?
If I can hypnotize Miss Lucy, we may be able to get her thoughts and Dracula's thoughts. And from those, he can locate her his confidence.
Oh, please, please, can't I help? I know the chapel. I can be a help. Please, just don't lock me up.
I will be sure to give you each individual attention. After all, you have worked long and hard to deserve rewards. Dr. Peter Seward, I presume. So nice to finally meet you. Your patient, Mr. Renfield, has told me so much about you. He says that you are a fair and just man. I hope his next keeper is as humane.
Don't be so positive, Count.
Oh, positive! Oh, positive! Ah, and you must be Abraham Van Helsing. Your friends call you Amy. Amy.
Snap off it, Count. Don't let your twine and don't throw us off guard. Be careful and do a job. And be male.
Ah, dear Arthur Holwood. I offer my deepest condolences. Dear Mina will be fondly remembered. Not a gourmet meal, mind you, but a delightful snack.
You dirty girl!
How dare you!